.com, a unique place for true gamers. The only place to bet on esports events. You know your way around a competitive gaming scene and are willing to take a risk? Watch regular broadcasts and earn real money. Esportsbets.com. Foresight, passion, and calculation.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We're right into the final map of this grand finals. It's going to be on Dust 2. Semla, are you ready? Are you here? This is the first question to be answered. Well, I'm guessing he's probably just gone for a drink, which is a good idea. You guys should do that too, because you don't want to be dehydrated or, you know, not at your senses here for this final map. And we don't have everyone joining yet, so it's all right. If you're just joining us here on the channel, then a big welcome to Room on Fire. This is the SLTV Starseries Grand Finals, and it's gone to all four maps. Fnatic came from the upper bracket after having beaten everyone up there, and they have a one-map lead going into this finals, but then they lost the first map on Mirage to NaVi. Then they won a terrific victory, really decisive, 16-3, was 16-3 on Inferno. And then on Train, they couldn't pull it through. They were in the middle of a pretty cool comeback, but they couldn't handle it this time. And then it was a coin toss between Dust 2 or Train. And Train would have been absolute disaster for NaVi. That would have been a killing blow. And it goes to Dust 2 instead. So I think now we have a really sick conclusion to this best of five, as it were. So yeah. Big welcome. Are you back, Semla?
Yeah, I'm back. I was just 2 seconds too late to catch you, and I didn't want to cut you off. So
it's all right.
No, you're right. I mean, that's it. Really, like the final map. I could hear. I'm excited, so I'm stumbling over my words. I could hear like the collective sigh of relief from both teams when the coin flip came back and it was Dust 2, right? Because I don't think either one of these would have wanted to finish this series on Nuke. So this is fantastic. Dust 2, I think both of these teams can really show us something special here. Guardian with the AWP, certainly, but NaVi have been playing a good Dust 2 map. The question is, we've seen what Fnatic are capable of, and I don't think it's been a very pleasant experience for their opponents either. So both of these teams, it's really tough to call who's going to have the advantage going into the final map, I think is the point I'm trying to make here.
Yeah, I really don't know. I still think Fnatic is favored overall, so I'm going to still give them a slight edge here on the final map, but I don't know. NaVi've been stepping it up, and I think both teams have been sort of rotating who's been the top player, so it's going to be interesting to see. I mean, Guardian on Dust 2 can be terrifying, right? This is where 30 and 40 bombs are dropped by this man, so if that happens, then NaVi have a very great chance of doing it. But it's not like Fnatic don't have a lot of tools as well. Remember, guys, if you haven't done it already, to follow the channel here, because we're actually just now, I think, 1,000 followers away from the 2,000 or the 200,000 mark. So go and do that if you haven't already, and we definitely appreciate it. And a big thanks also to our subscriber team that's been cool all throughout the day. That's absolutely wonderful. And there's also a Facebook link at the bottom of the page. If you haven't clicked it yet, then there's a picture down there for a raffle. I think right now it's an AK racing chair, but in the next 8 weeks, you can win all kinds of stuff. So if you haven't won, just keep clicking and keep liking, and you'll be good to go.
Yeah, exactly. It's just one like, and you're going to be open up to 8 raffles. We're going to be running that all the way until mid-October, basically, every week with our Kiss King of the Hill tournament that happens on Tuesday nights. So every Tuesday night from here on out until mid-October, we'll be having two best of threes, basically, per night. Nip are currently sitting on the throne. We'll let you know over the next couple of days, you know, who's going to be taking a crack at them this week. But yeah, there's stuff given away every week if you like that page. But this is ROF Semler, please. I know we need to get better about the emotes too, man. Yeah, we gotta get a couple of those out. It's been so hectic, guys, but don't worry, it's definitely on the to-do list, putting those emotes into the channel so you guys can have some new emotes to play with. It's a goal.
It's happening, don't worry. We're just very lazy, but eventually we'll get around to it. But here it comes, the knife round, so let's get it on. This is Room on Fire in the SLTV Star Series Season 10 Grand Finals, the final map. Right now the map score is 2-2, and whoever wins here is going to be walking home with a first place victory, and that's definitely going to mean something for both teams.
This is going to be huge. Fnatic will take a title win, And NaVi, I think this is the almost bigger for NaVi, because NaVi were knocked out of Gamescom, the last major, just a couple weeks ago by this very team. So they have a bone to pick. They want to preserve their title, their Star Series title, because they won Star Series 9, but also they want to get revenge for Gamescom that just happened a couple weeks ago. So a lot to prove here for NaVi in this final map, and it's perfect. Dust 2 is going to be a very exciting map to settle it all on.
And now we have the team huddles, just like we had before. Just everyone getting ready. And I think especially for the pistol round, right? If you're on the final map, you wanna be off to that great pistol start, take the victory. Especially if you're on Fnatic on the CT side here. And I mean, actually doubly so if you're Fnatic, because if Fnatic get off to a good start in the pistol and pick up two AWPs, one on Olaf and one on JW, that could lead to an almost impenetrable defense, I think, on the CT side.
Do you think we should make an Aqua Chicken emote, Anders?
It could be, right? I think we have. I think the standard is like 10 emotes, and right now, obviously, we have some older ones lying around too. So we're gonna have to just go through one day and see what is needed.
I think we've got. I think there is one of me with the hat, so we might be doing that. I think we're also gonna focus on like a 1-for-1 or something like that. But after that, I don't know. We'll come up with it. If you guys have any ideas, go and check out our subreddit. It's reddit.com/r/roomonfire. And if you have any ideas at all for an emote, if you want to make one, if you want to do anything like that, feel free to post them there, because we check that Reddit daily. That's where you guys can stay in touch with the community, or, you know, around the channel. And also, you know, basically our site is launched. So if you guys want to check it out there as well, keep up to date with what's been going on with the channel, etc., you guys can go and check it out at roomonfire.tv. But yeah, let's go ahead, man. We got to get in this.
And you just said that in front of 51,000 people, so I'm assuming that means right now our site's just basically crashed, because that's like what? The internet hog of death. All right, that happens.
Don't do it, guys. Take it easy on it.
Yeah, take turns to visit the site, right? Yeah, so apart from that, it's just been an absolutely amazing grand finals. It's rare that we get to see all five maps in a best of five, because I know it just always ends a little bit differently. And for once, we actually end up on a map that NaVi can play too, so that's good.
I mean, it's really rare that we actually have this format in CSGO, best of fives. I mean, if we go back to ESEA, for example, the sick comeback from All Out Power when they took on Titan, they had to reset the bracket. It was two back-to-back best of threes. And that's the usual. I mean, usually that's how it goes. Usually we don't have the double elimination bracket as well. So when you're getting into it, a best of five final is a real pleasure to watch, just because it's just, it changes up how things are played out.
It definitely does.
No, right. The site is down.
Yeah. The internet.
What have I done?
That's what happens, guys. If you can actually do that to a lot of site, it's almost like a really sort of low-tech DDoS version. Just get like, you know, get like 50,000 people on your stream and ask them to visit one in particular site, and it'll probably crash. So, unless okay. It's been set up.
Right. Well, yeah, we'll look into better hosting in the future, right?
Yeah, that's on the menu too, guys. We're still working on the website, and we've got great help with it. So, it's gonna be even better. Don't you worry. Man, I want them to stop huddling and start shooting each other instead, because I'm getting more and more excited by the second here. I really think this Dust 2 map could be quite interesting.
No, this is gonna be it, man. But then again, these guys, they've got to get in that frame of mind, right? The proper frame of mind. A whole tournament now rides on this final map. And how are you gonna play this final map? Is it gonna be all out aggression? Is it gonna be patience? I think we're gonna see a real healthy mix of everything here, Anders. But I really expect to see the team starting on CT side to come out swinging, basically. Because if you get a strong start on the CT side of Dust 2, that's gonna be fantastic for you going into this final map. I'm still just blown away that we got the final map in a best of five, that it comes down to Dust 2 to settle it all.
Yeah, that's definitely, that's sort of a breath of fresh air, because way too often we end up with a 2-0 victory for one team, and that sort of ends it a little bit wrong. And considering how well Fnatic have been playing all throughout the tournament, there was a real chance that was going to happen as well. So, NaVi, luckily I think they've managed to come back and show us some great action.
They have, especially being able to bounce back on Train after the thrashing they took on Inferno from Fnatic. So that's a true testament to NaVi's experience, I think, as a team. Because we are talking about legends on the, you know, it's NaVi from 1.6 pretty much, minus Markolov. So these guys have got thousands and thousands of hours on LAN. This is definitely, you know, a team that can bounce back in that sort of situation.
And also honorable shout out to Senia, just to not forget.
Senia's here?
No, I just meant like, you know, he usually in the NaVi lineup.
Senia's probably casting this game right now.
Probably is. And he's become quite popular as well in the Russian streaming circle, so that's great. He's a very funny guy too, so.
If you want to see the fifth member from the legendary NaVi lineup, he streams quite a bit actually now, handling the Ukrainian language, but also he streams on Case Kings on Tuesday night. So if you guys want to change it up a little bit, you know, go and watch Senia. He's streaming quite a bit these days. Really cool to see. But it looks like, Anders, it looks like this is it. It's the beginning of the end.
Finally live, and it's going to be a bit of a push towards the B-bomb site, but not really sort of committing to it, just checking upper and lower dock, and they're actually going to run right into Pronax, who instantly falls back, so that's good news.
Whoa, and JW actually catches Edward peeking over at Longhouse, and that's a great start here for Fnatic, getting the first frag. Now the question is, where do NaVi decide to go from here? They're trying to go for a bit of a cheek jump shot towards flush on B slope, but NaVi have now rotated around to Cat. They're going to have three guys pushing up here, all four potentially in just a moment's time, and they're going to have to land some sick hot headshots. They have to get the shots very quickly, but JW is holding from A site, and he's already going to force NaVi back just with the force of his presence.
Yeah, and they're going to run, and actually the cool thing is that he goes and checks, so he knows a hell of a lot of what was happening right now on the NaVi side, and he's communicating it to his teammate. Look at how Fnatic as a whole unit are just making it work, but the entry frag on Flusher could change everything. Your Crims has to stay alive, and he won't. Cease will take him down, and that might actually be the thing that settles this for NaVi. This is now going to be a really tough retake here for Fnatic.
Still a 3-on-3, and JW is already pressuring them at the window. Finally, Cease is going to be able to put this bomb down, but NaVi, they've been under pressure. They're not going to have the best after plant positions, and the flank is coming in from Olafmeister as well through upper dark. So this is going to turn into the pincer movement here. Pronax rocks in and gets one frag. Olafmeister finally going to stand his ground, taking on the fight versus Stars, and it's going to come down to Seized, but Pronax has enough HP. They have the time for the defuse as well, even without a kit. In Fnatic, they managed to stabilize at the end. NaVi, in a 3-on-3, weren't able to hold.
Oh god, Pronax, he actually went looking for a kit. That's really scary. If he had spent another second doing that, that could have been kind of disastrous. He did find the kit eventually, but I guess somebody probably told him it's up on the plateau and he couldn't find it. That could have been horrible, but it works out. Fnatic retake it, and it's 1-0.
Yeah, a little bit of a heart attack moment there. Crims also carrying the kit. That would have been like one of the ultra facepalm moments, like one of the biggest facepalm moments in LAN history, I think, for CSGO.
Yeah, that would be a great way to crash the grand finals for yourself, right? Just winning the pistol round and then looking for a kit and never finding it and then losing the pistol after all. That would be very hard to deal with. A bit of a hiccup here on GoTV or maybe a pause, I'm not sure, but we're right back into it.
Yeah, barely a second loss there, but now NaVi not wasting any time at all. They lose that round, but they still decide to go for a force buy here. So NaVi not willing to give Fnatic any kind of momentum early on. They want to make sure that they keep the pressure up. Just like Fnatic did in that bomb plant situation in the last round, now NaVi, with this buy, are just looking to see if they can catch Fnatic off guard early on. Fnatic not messing around, though. They have two guys holding on this B site. Solid. Although Flusha is starting to work his way down to slope, but hopefully he doesn't go too far away because it's really going to come down to holding this push right here.
Crims goes down. Flusha now sandwiched in, and Olafmeister's going to help him out. Flusha's still dropping pretty low. I'm wondering if this is Navi's homage to Hellraisers, just saying, all right, you might be out of the tournament, but we'll still honor you with a bit of a mad buy in the second round. And so far, it's working out really great. And this position from Edward could be critical. The bomb is planted for him as well, and he's going to maybe, he can catch two people coming up a dark. That would be big.
That would be huge. JW is going to go rushing past. He's going to be the first man past. Is Edward going to be patient, though? Edward takes his time. He could blind them both up, and Edward with the double spray. Flusha tries to push through the doors, and he will get two quick frags. Pulls a 180, and now it's all down to Edward in upper dark. Gets the first frag, and he gets the second as well. Edward saves it with a quad kill to put NaVi on the board and get that second round.
Whoa. Yet more evidence that, aim is really important, but having the right position and being able to read what's happening in the game, you know, 10 seconds from where you are, which is still really hard. It's kind of like chess, you know. So only so many moves you can think ahead. And Edward, I don't know, he thought very far ahead at that point in time. That was great play. And that secures NaVi the second round.
That was brilliant. The patience not to give his position away when JW goes leaping past. The patience to just go for it, be greedy, and that's when it pays off to be greedy, right? He's being smart about it, and he lets them go by, and Fnatic don't even think to check T-spawn. That's a big mistake there on Fnatic's part. Excuse me, you guys probably heard that. But Edward just really single-handedly making that happen there, because the defense, that was also just a huge play by Flusha. I mean, going through the doors so quickly, getting the guy on the left by Carr, but then being able to do a 180 and pick, I think it was Guardian, off of Plateau so quickly like that, I could have swore that Edward was going to get overwhelmed.
Yeah, I agree. It looked like, but it just didn't work out that way. I'm wondering, is Edward making Matrix references? Or is it like a translation thing? To be honest, the Na'Vi members, they all speak English just fine, so I'm going to call that a Matrix thing.
Not like this? Is that what Edward said right there in that last round?
Yeah, except he didn't get shot in the face or get unplugged. He actually just went ham on them. It's going to be the third round coming up, and Fnatic shouldn't try and force it up ice. I mean, they could go for like CSET 75 armor, but Pronax? They might do it. I would rather them saving for that double up setup, but they're going to try and bounce right back. Interesting.
It's Fnatic now going for it. Fnatic, I don't necessarily mind it as much on Fnatic's side that he's going. I think Vendetta right now would just be like, I don't know, I can't get behind this. But Fnatic or CT side, they're on the less favored side, and they really only need like 6 rounds. So if they go for a risk and it works here at the early, they're not really throwing away the half. So I think this is actually a pretty decent opportunity for them, except that Edward and Guardian double team Olafmeister at long, and Pronax gets chased back into CT spawn.
Oh, yeah, I'm not sure. Olafmeister, I appreciate him taking the first shot like that, but it felt like re-peaking was going to be quite rough. And they're complaining about some lag issues, which I think is why we paused a couple of seconds ago. But I think it's going to be, hopefully.
Okay, well, hopefully this is going to even out a little bit here. And well, this is the last map. It would be incredibly shameful for it to be a lag issue that settles things here between the teams. But then again, it's on land. They're going to have everybody there to make sure that they can get this fixed as quickly as possible. Flusha on Cat gets overwhelmed, but JW does manage to get 2 very nice frags to even things up here. Into a 2-on-3 we go, as Zeus is now looking for the way to a site, and he is going to decide to go to the B side along with Starix.
Yeah, there's not much they can do about that, Fnatic, unfortunately. JW doing a really great job, and I mean, these kills do matter at the end. Even if they can't win the round, and obviously with Cease being all the way over here, he's going to be able to backstab them, so he's been waiting a long time already. It's going to be a big problem for Crims here. Should be almost a free kill when he walks out in the middle. Crims, though, hiding in the corner. Actually, if Cease keeps running like this, Crims might pick it up, but the timing is not there. And I think Crims heard him just as he saw him. They can't win the round.
It was the sixth sense. There was a glitch, and Crims saw it coming. He knew. But at this point, the bomb will not be getting defused at any point in time. It is going to be seized, actually, most likely to pick up a frag here. JW, fairly low HP. Seized could catch JW off guard. JW looking towards A slope, but it's not good. Or at least he's not quick enough. Seized will react first and get the headshot. Now Crim's kind of boxed in here.
Yeah, I think Crim's going to survive the round, but that's still a little bit unfortunate. It would have been great if they could have saved 2 AKs like that. I still think that's it's not a great round from Fnatic, and now obviously they have to eco once more. But I think at worst, this is going to be 3-1 to Na'Vi, and at which point Fnatic are going to be back in the money. So I wouldn't panic just yet for the Swedish team here.
Yeah, 3-1 or 4-1. It comes down to how Fnatic want to play this out. If they want to buy early or if they want to just eco another and get maximum money to be able to deal with Na'Vi. The one thing here is that, you know, it's an educated risk, basically. You're just saying, okay, we take a risk. If it doesn't pay off, all right. Now we just have to do some damage to Na'Vi, basically, to make sure that their money doesn't get out of control, because Na'Vi could have 2 golden rounds here to just start building a bank, and then life gets very difficult for a Fnatic, because they're not just going to be able to put Na'Vi on eco right away. They have to deal with back-to-back fire rounds. And Crims with a nice spray, doing a little bit of damage to Seized as well. That's going to benefit Flusha, who manages to rack up a frag of his own. And there's 2 kills already for Fnatic.
So really, I think there was a real chance that Crims could have killed 2 or even 3 people there. That was very, very close. And that would have settled the round. Edward does go down, but he's Olafmeister's also going to be alone here. He wants to pick up that AK, and they're going to help him push it a little bit further. But
and the smoke going down as well.
If he had got that spray for the smoke, that would have been so disgusting, but it works out. He's going to be running away, and I think actually already Zeus is trying to look for him here, but Olafmeister smokes up for his own escape, and Zeus not quite spotting him.
Oh, this is a dangerous game. Olafmeister with the mind games. He's going back towards B now. Oh, I like it. This is perfect. Na'Vi are going to be all the way on the other side of the map hunting for him, and Olafmeister will be able to hold on to this AK now. 43, 46, yeah, they should be going for a buy here, Fnatic, especially because Olafmeister holds on to that AK. He can get full gear, no problem at all.
Yeah,
a well-equipped Fnatic now in the fifth round.
It's a bit of a shame that nobody could pick up an AWP. That would have been fun, especially because they saved the AK, so they would have been able to spread it out. But even rifles should be alright for Fnatic. And be nice if they can step it back immediately here so that Na'Vi don't start building up too much of an economy. 3-1 is the scoreline. We're still in the first half of this final map here. And it's the grand finals, in case you're wondering. So everything is on the line.
This is it, the title. Na'Vi, the defense of their title. Fnatic, their first Star Series title. And more importantly, Fnatic, having lost Gamescom, I think they're looking to get a title of their own on land here. It's not going to be a major title, but still, they need a first place, I think. And that would be very big for them indeed.
Yeah, I mean, SLTV has a lot of history, so it's definitely not nothing, even though it's not $250,000 we're competing for. I still think Fnatic, and I think everyone takes this quite seriously. And, I mean, it's close. It's still close. Fnatic are on the less favored side. It's way too early to call a winner. I like this position from Crims, and especially Flusher can get in to help out before Crims goes down. Could be a really powerful crossfire. Crims gonna open up, picks the last one, and he does get two before he goes down. Now Flusher is gonna pick off where his teammate left off, and he actually almost kills Edward, but doesn't quite.
He does the damage, and Edward does manage to make the leap past the doors as well, survives the hail of bullets coming in through B slope. It's going to be the upper dark play here, however, but Zeus is waiting and ready. 9 HP left on him, though. He's going to be chased back, and JW will hunt him down in the end. The YOLO play from Edward straight out onto B slope into the waiting arms of two members of Fnatic, and now it's all Guardian, alive alone, at the back of Plateau. He's going to get smoked off. He's in the open, but Olafmeister will find him in the end, and that is going to be enough time for the defuse here for Fnatic, picking up their second round.
That was actually a very intelligent play from JW, who saw the top fragging on Fnatic right here. Coming up from Lord Dark, he actually jumped and anticipated Zeus being there. So he simply jumped and headshot him down to 8 points of health. That was a sick little detail. That's the kind of stuff that's worth looking out for, because you know you're dealing with a player of quite high caliber if you can spot stuff like this. And that's not like a normal jump spot, put it like that. It's not on the A-bomb site where you can always see people jumping for a kill. A Guardian opens up with a kill and goes for a second one and takes JW, and that's bad.
That's real bad. that's not going to help things at all. Edward alive in a house. This is, Fnatic at this point need to kind of try and push out somewhere to get some information, figure out where Na'Vi are going to be coming from. And it looks like Na'Vi, they realize that the defense is going to be weakest on Cat. They're just barreling up onto this A site. The bomb is going to be coming through. And now Na'Vi, they're going to be able to deal with Olafmeister, who's at half HP on A long, gets caught out in the open. He still gets one kill on Starx, but that's not going to be good enough right now. It's a 2-on-4, and Fnatic are no closer to getting control of this site.
Chronax takes down one. Grenade to follow would actually soften up and Guardian a little bit, but the fact that Flush is all the way over here and Chronax is going to get caught by Edward, it does not bode well for Fnatic. And they're still complaining a little bit about some lag issues, although it seems to be mostly even. They don't understand, they're on the same server, and Seast and Starks have slightly lower ping than everyone else, and also Chronax, so this is just a very weird issue. Hopefully going to get it sorted out without too much of a delay.
Yeah, we are jumping, oddly enough, up to like 70 ping right now, so when usually they float around 5. Curious if we're going to have a pause coming in to rectify this. Flusher alive, manages to get the shot on Zeus and T-Spawn though, and nobody else is close enough from Na'Vi. Ah, but apparently it's internet all over Ukraine.
Oh, well, that's an issue. They're waiting on some info, and they're paused in the meantime, which gives us an opportunity, guys, to welcome anyone new who's joining us. We hope you will follow the channel. I think last count, we were about 500 followers away from the 200,000 follower mark, and we definitely do appreciate you guys following us. If you can, it'll help us out a lot. And you can also follow us on Twitter if you haven't already. So that's at OnFireSemler. It's at VendettaGo, who is not here right now, but he's, you know, been with us throughout the rest of the day. And it's OnFireAnders, and then also at Room on Fire CSGO if you want to do that. But yeah, go and do that.
And we are currently paused, so it does look like they're going to get some info from the admins. Seized saying that they are at war, that the war has started. Not something to take lightly, but right now, Na'Vi. Well, right now, Na'Vi, what's going through their minds is basically, you know, stabilizing this situation, because Flusha has managed to hold on to an AWP. Fnatic don't quite have the money to go for a buy here, so Navi, this is all about getting through this round right now with taking minimal damage from Fnatic, making sure that, you know, they deal with Flesha. They know there's an AWP somewhere on the map. Avoid him, deal with the rest of them, and build up a little bit of bank.
And, I mean, just to, you know, all jokes aside, it was actually the political situation that sort of prevented Mouseports from going here. They weren't feeling quite sure about it. At least some of the players weren't. But, yeah, my XMG stepped it up instead. As far as I know, the conflicts happening in Ukraine are happening pretty far to the southeast and not so much towards towards where Kiev is. Should be pretty safe, I think. But, you know, internet issues are never fun anyway.
Well, yeah, that's the thing. If it's countrywide, it's kind of countrywide, right? That's going to be a bit of a problem. Yeah, we're still floating around the 70 ping mark right now. The one thing that's the real problem here is that this is an opportunity. This could actually throw the teams off somewhat. If it all comes down to who's going to be able to keep their cool and not get annoyed, really. They need to just stay focused on the task, stay focused on this last map, and not allow themselves to become distracted by what's going on either outside of the map or what's going on right now that's affecting their gameplay. So I think the team that keeps their cool throughout this pause is going to be the one that comes out ahead once we resume the game.
Yeah, I mean, that's something we've been talking about pretty much every single time. There's been sort of a pause like this throughout the finals, is that generally the team that's a little bit behind and maybe could use a mental reset are probably going to benefit from it a little bit more. But what is Fnatic actually doing? That's what I'm wondering, because Flusher bought an AWP and armor. Did he save? No, he saved this from last
he
round.
He saved
sorry,
that
yeah,
from the last
I'm,
round.
I'm just making things up. All right. That's an important difference, because you really don't want one guy buying an AWP like this, so I guess the name of the game for Fnatic is either getting Flusher to actually win the round with an AWP, which can happen, especially on Dust 2, or just saving it for the next round.
Yeah, I think that's going to be it. Just hold on to Flusher, make sure you can cover him, because he's got the Kevlar helmet, so he's going to be a bit tougher. If he can, and he can actually AWP Flusher as well. Not as well as Olafmeister and JW, but he's definitely proficient with the gun. So maybe if they can get Flusher into a good position, he can manage to make the difference here for Fnatic, but I think a lot more importance is going to be put on making sure that no matter who lives, somebody holds onto that AWP for the next round. But we should be unpausing fairly soon here and getting back into it. It seems like all the players are ready. The ping has stabilized, and hopefully we get back into the mix and see who's actually going to take this seventh round.
Apparently Putin's DDoS has failed, which is the rumor that's going around. Feels to me like he probably has other things on his mind right now, but you never know, right?
We're going up in ping again.
Really?
Yeah, and it's actually uniform across the board, practically. 52, 60.
It seems to be like three of the players are immune to the rise in ping, and the rest are more susceptible. I'm not sure what's going on.
You can't slow Pronax down.
No, apparently not, but the rest of his team... Oh, man. So, of course, we apologize for this weird delay, but, you know, as soon as we're back, we're going to get back in the action. It's the final map as well, so we just want to see how this all plays out. I mean, so far, the Grand Finals has been so solid. It's been such a great Grand Finals that, you know, we need to see the rest of it. We want to see how it ends.
No, this is... Let me see. Sorry, checking a couple things real quick.
While you're checking things, I'm going to try and see if I can actually figure out how many followers we're up to. So keep asking.
What's the point? Well, we're really close. If this is live update, we're like 200, not even 130 followers away from breaking 200,000. That would be huge.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
That would be
too.
A very fine cap to the month.
Yeah, that would make us happy. And obviously, then we need to set a new goal and figure out what that's going to be. But, I don't know. I guess like some of the top channels, like some of the LOL channels, they have like, is it like 500,000 or is it even like 1 million followers? I can't remember.
I have no idea. Maybe LCS or something like that, right? Those guys are just nuts.
Dude, there are so many LOL players, but there are more and more Counter-Strike players too. So, you know, we're getting up there. Actually, yeah. Riot Games is actually just a little bit short of 1 million, and Syndicate somehow has more than 1 million. Interesting. All right. There's a competition going on. I'm not sure we can beat everybody, but we're certainly going to try, right? Spread the good word about our Counter-Strike game here.
I'm going to bring my mic a little bit closer, because apparently I'm echoing a little bit. So, hopefully this solves it, guys. But right now, yeah, I mean, we're still waiting right now to see exactly how things are going to go. Guardian is having the time of his life right now. He's just, you know, apparently he can't stop laughing. I mean, this is just great.
Oh, man. Wow. It's good that they're having fun, at least. It's good that they're having fun. So, I mean, what do you make of this so far, Semler? It's 2-4, and it seemed like NaVi... I mean, that last round where Guardian starts off picking off two people in the middle, you can't really rely on that being, like, a solid strat. That's not going to happen every single round. I'm actually still waiting for Fnatic to pull out that double AWP. That's what I want.
Oh, I agree. That's a strong play that Fnatic can go for. The problem with it is that they haven't had the money to be able to do that yet. So they really need to be... I mean, they had the pistol, but that's not quite enough. And after that, I don't think they've really been able to be able to do that quite yet. So, I mean, if Olafmeister and JW can actually save up enough and be able to split up and put those ops to work, it's going to be great. But can any of them really go toe-to-toe with Guardian right now, I think, is the question on Dust 2, because Guardian seems to be fired up. He's sitting at 6-1-5 right now. But that last round was basically Guardian giving it to his team with those two kills at mid.
Yeah, and you know, again, that kind of starts kind of ridiculous. Normally, you'll feel glad if you can tag someone jumping by, or even just spot someone so you have an idea about how many people are going where. Double kill is a little bit too much to ask for. They're still waiting for some sort of answer. I mean, everyone's ping is low, but I guess nobody wants to start and then have the ping rise right when the action happens.
200k, what's up, guys? Spam the flames. Yeah, awesome.
Absolutely great. Thank you,
everyone. Thanks to all the followers out there, guys. That's sick.
Yeah, this channel, technically speaking, started sometime last year, March last year, basically, was when we started collecting. So that's quite impressive. I have no idea how many followers that is per day. I'm not so good at maths, but it's we really do appreciate it, all the support. And, you know, we're going to try and bring as much back in return as we can to the community, because it's pretty much you guys that make it possible. So we really appreciate it. Moving into the seventh round, finally it seems like they're back online and the ping is all right, and they have this one AWP which is actually kind of aggressive. Look at this.
They're really putting this to work right now. Olafmeister was the one taking the peek. He didn't have the gear, so it's not a problem if he goes for it. Now Flusha is going to look like he wants to get over to look towards cross, towards the CT mid doors right now, because NaVi are going for a B split push. Four guys rushing straight up B slope. Crims is waiting close around the corner with that CZ75. Going to go for the first shot. He does manage to pick up one, but that is it. Two quick kills come in, and NaVi get control of the B bomb site and should be able to just wrap up this round fairly quickly here, although Olafmeister isn't too far away.
Flush just gotta be careful he doesn't lose the AWP here. That's like the one thing that actually cannot happen, and Seuss is very close by here, trying to deny it to him. He's got a pistol, and more people are coming. One more bullet than either of these players is gonna work, but this is frightening. Grenade lands in, he's gonna miss the shot, and they lose the AWP. That's very bad news for Fnatic.
At this point, oh man, Fnatic are going to force up again, though. I mean, they can force up, but... I don't know. Yeah, you force up and you go for it, I suppose. But at the same time, it's like you give one more round to NaVi, but you get maximum. You get a maximum buy-in, maybe an op, like one op or a double op play sort of strategy. Guardian is going to have to spawn for long right now, and he is set up. JW kind of playing with that angle. Doesn't quite land the nade, but are they going to find the opportunity to take Guardian out here? Guardian still holds, but he decides to back off in the end, not willing to put too much time into that one position.
Yeah, so nicely handled by Fnatic, not getting picked off by that early spawn. That would be a grave mistake to make once you're already forcing up. And I definitely don't agree with this kind of buy up here. But if Fnatic can make it work, then that would be a big opening back, like right back in the game, basically.
Yeah, pretty much. If somehow they could find that way in. I mean, right now, NaVi, you do kind of like exactly what they're going for here, though. I don't necessarily like that they relinquish control so early on long, but still. Just gonna go for the rush up cat, pretty much putting pressure on the Fnatic defense and forcing them to rotate around. Just making sure that Fnatic can't get too comfortable with their hold.
Flusher down the middle, just spotting a couple of people and doing a little bit of damage onto Starix. Not bad. And Fnatic are really, I mean, they're a cool team in this sense. They don't move around too much. You can see they're holding their positions and staying focused, but they're not sort of, you know, wildly rotating all over the map.
No, they really are taking their time with it. Guardian will find the kill on Olafmeister, though. That's over on A, so now perhaps NaVi decide to go through, although JW does find a kill on Edward in Longhouse. Flusha finds Zeus as well, and that's going to slow things down considerably here. NaVi, two guys left on Cat, but only 9 seconds left. They actually don't have time to win this round.
No,
the
they
bomb
really
gets
don't.
Dropped, and they cannot win. NaVi, run the clock down.
A lot of great individual moments in this round, and Guardian goes down after the time runs out, so look at the money for him. Not going to be that great, and NaVi should be ecoing here. Really a lot of individual play from Fnatic in this round, and it brought them a victory. So that's just amazing, especially I think JW picking off Edward over on long. Because if he had lost long control, they would have been sandwiched in on the A bomb side, and that just basically never happened.
No, that was just... Exactly. But that was just a crucial kill, you're right, onto Edward in longhouse. Edward with the long spawn actually gets pre-fired there by JW. Nice work of the angle. But they do manage to go for a bit of a buy here on Navi's side. Guardian has that AWP glass cannon. Three rifles to work with, but not too many nades. So NaVi are going to fully commit out mid-doors right now, looking to see if they can't find a pick somewhere. But Flush is going to chase them back around the corner. Flush are going with the spray. Tracks down Starks, and that's one of the rifles down for NaVi.
Very nice for Fnatic. This is where they can really bounce back. If NaVi lose this round because they did force it up, it's almost like they're going to be double ecoing on the terrorist side, and that's very far from what you want to do. And it seems like Fnatic, I don't know if it's the pause or if it's just, you know, one of the resources they have on the team here, but they seem to have sort of found their strength again.
Now, they've kind of recovered somewhat, and they've still got all, I mean, they've got the rifles and the gear. Now they just need to convince themselves they can land the shots, essentially, and already winning that round was very nicely done. They need to hold back from Guardian, who eats a full nade to the face, pretty much, down to 19 HP. The cat play is here. NaVi, there you go. Siege finds Pronax on a slope. Siege with the double kill, the double entry frag, and that's what we need to look to Siege to do here for NaVi. Get those kills that create opportunities for his team.
Flusher is sneaking close. I don't think they realize he's here, and he's going to get the opening kill on Guardian. This is not at all bad. Down to a 3-on-3, and he can actually pick up two more. He's going to take one. It's now a double, and Siege has now revealed himself. This is actually not a great position at all. Siege is going to walk out, and it's Crims to take the last two. And Flusher with a triple in total. Very nice retake from Fnatic.
The jumping shot from the M4 there, from Crims at the end. That is ridiculous that he manages to land that at that range as well. Because you've seen more and more of it where the bomb is being planted for long or for short, for example, and a guy will jump up point blank with the M4. But to get it at that range, the jumping shot, that's pretty sick. And now this is actually somewhat of a worst case scenario for NaVi. They're starting to lose control in this round. They actually have to go for an eco round, whereas Fnatic have all the money. They are fully equipped right now, not even having used a nade. Crims is the only one to have thrown one down yet.
That's interesting, isn't it? So it's a big turnaround, and just a couple of rounds, it swings back in favor of Fnatic, and NaVi were looking really good. But now they're ecoing, and even getting into a bombsite is going to be tricky. They do pick up the first kill, and actually Flusher gets dinked a little bit too. That grenade not doing much for him. He's going to go for the spray on Edward, but he gets shut down, and weirdly, it's a 3-on-3 with two rifles being picked up from NaVi and the bomb plant.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Crim's standing his ground at the B doors like that, but NaVi just too good about landing the shots in the end. That's the real problem here. Two rifles picked up for NaVi to work with as well makes this retake very difficult for Fnatic. They have to hit their shots perfectly as they try and make their way through, but they do have Pronax on a bit of a wraparound through upper dark. JW and Olafmeister will be working on B slope, but now the play begins, and Edward with the jumping CZ straight to Olaf's face. Wake up, Edward. That was perfect.
Yeah, up in the window, and also coming up from the plateau, Guardian actually doesn't connect until the very last second, and they will get the round. Are they going to blow up? They will both die with the bomb, so Fnatic lose the round. They can probably still force it up, and considering they've been doing it so far, I wouldn't be surprised if they do it again here. They will, and NaVi really don't have any money, so this is do or die time. Whoever loses this upcoming round, it's probably going to take another round after that basically for free.
Yeah, essentially, and then it's getting way too close to the end for comfort, so Fnatic, they're really committing to just shutting NaVi down in this round. It's so important that they do so. JW just putting shots through with the Swag 7 at long, completely blind, through the smoke, not going to connect with anybody. Edward is low, and JW finds him, the headshot through the smoke, blind, counting on Olafmeister, giving away the position of his enemies on the minimap. That is some sick skill there, JW.
Yeah, now more people are showing up. Fnatic have them trapped in here. Seuss is going to go down. Fnatic really just locking down NaVi out on long, and they're going to try and escape. You can see Guardian really wants to get out from behind that blue container. But if he just runs, he might get picked off. So he's waiting for them now. He's going to go back again. And it's just him and Starix left.
No, they're hunting him down. Guardian is just going to try and hide through the smoke. Are you... JW, did he really just try and go for a knife?
Yeah, he did. And Guardian is going to punish it a little bit. Takes down one. Still a 1-on-3. He still wants to do it. But JW is going to pick it up. And it will be 5-6. Yeah, he did go for a knife in that smoke.
You gotta love JW. He's like the one guy who thinks, okay, this guy's gonna be hiding in the corner in the smoke. He's not gonna see me coming. I'm going to knife and get an extra 1500 bucks. Now, that is pretty damn cool. And that was actually a great, just a great opening round of aggression from Fnatic. It allowed them to get full control of that situation at long so quickly. JW staying alive, Olafmeister more importantly staying alive in pit, never really allowing Guardian to escape.
And now they're being herded around the map. They really don't know where to go, and no matter where they run, there's going to be someone waiting with a pistol or a rifle, or even worse, an AWP from JW. So Edward here, not much of a chance. It's going to be 6-6 again. They're Fnatic going to equalize the score, and this is really great news.
Wow. That nade not doing it. Olafmeister has to go in with the rifle to finish the job. But yeah, 6-6, the gamble works for Fnatic. That's the most important part of that last round. Now NaVi are the ones who are going to go for a bit of a mixed buy. Zeus, not even wasting any time. 3,500 in the bank. You go straight for Galil armor and a couple nades. So this is now NaVi who are putting a lot on the line here. If they don't pick up this round, they're going to be hard-pressed to get a reasonable buy-in at the last. They can't afford to let Fnatic come out ahead in rounds at the end of this first half. That's pretty much it. Like, they just, that is not an option right now for NaVi. They need to get the remaining three.
JW doesn't connect down in lower dark, and the grenade doesn't do much either. So NaVi, they escape unscathed at that point in time. But I think you're right. This is where Fnatic sort of can really win the first half. Not the whole game, but definitely the first half.
Absolutely. And it's just, I mean, a big momentum shift if they do manage to pull that off, because that's going to be a lot of confidence going into that second half as well, knowing you have a bit of a cushion to play with. You're going to be on the favored side. Fnatic on the brink right here of having a major advantage going into the remainder of this map that is going to settle the title here of Star Series 10. Olafmeister is alive on that A site, going to be looking towards Cat. Is he going to find the shot fast enough, though? He is still alive. He goes for the peek, and Zeus insta-gives him with the Galil. Not even any time.
And a bit of a landslide in this round for NaVi. They started off with a kill on Pronax down on long and really left Olafmeister in an awkward position here. Great shot through the smoke from JW, but I think they're going to run away and try and save these rifles.
It seems like Fnatic aren't even wasting any time with it either. They're just calling for the back instantly. As soon as they realize that the bomb is planted for long, there's going to be certainly a man long. And NaVi have managed to get good after plant positions. JW looking. He doesn't manage to catch Zeus crossing, however, so that's a missed opportunity there. In the meantime, it's Seized who's out on the map hunting for Fnatic members, seeing if he can track anybody down. Hey, what I want to see right now, basically, is for Fnatic to have the money somehow. Will they be able to have the money? Yeah, JW still has his AWP.
Yeah,
and he has enough money to buy it again next round. There we go, that's it. This is the change of pace, Anders. You're getting your wish.
Finally. I mean, we're in the 14th round, so I'm tempted to not be entirely pleased still, but I guess it's better late than never. Double ops, but Guardian just doing Guardian things here in the middle, taking down Flusher as he crosses over. Ah, that's annoying.
That is definitely not going to be... That's not a very pleased Flusher. Olafmeister still has an AWP, and he manages to find Edward at Longhouse. That's the kill that needed to happen for Fnatic. They needed to get the information, and if they could, pick up a frag. And Olafmeister does both, so that's very nice work there. Even 4-on-4, but NaVi still with the advantage, considering, you know, it's an even situation regarding manpower. But NaVi are still on the T side. Fnatic have to cover more ground with less at this point. So NaVi, are they going to shift up and try and go for another B play? It seems like it. They're going for the CT smoke, and they're working the bomb into upper dark. It seems like, once again, NaVi are going to be focusing on taking this B site.
JW, he has to land a shot. If he misses just... I mean, he can maybe miss one and get a second chance, but if he misses two, they're going to be so close it won't even matter. Guardian coming out here. Great flashbang. JW will pick up one and run into the site here, and Krim's pushing upper. It's going to go down to Starix, and that leaves JW in a strange position, but he's still going to pick up a triple. Turns around, goes for the quad, and he might have still won the round for his team here.
1v2. This is feasible for Starix, though, because he's going to be able to get the plant fairly early. Both members moving up B slope right now, but Starix has got the smoke for upper dark. Olafmeister is looking to see if anybody's going to be peeking out through the window right now. Good flashes going in. Starks rushes out window. He tries to catch one off guard, but those flashes prevented him from really doing anything at all there, and Olafmeister will get the frag early on. So Fnatic, they managed to recover in the end, and they will even be able to save two AWPs for the final round of this half.
Yeah, so a big individual performance from JW. Really great. Even a little bit of sort of artwork into it at the end as he jumps out the window with the CZ-75 and takes down the third player. If you could have got the fourth one, that would have just been icing on top, but he still basically won the round for his team. 7-7, and we're moving into the 15th round, the last one of the first half here in the final map of this Grand Finals.
Man, that's just JW right there. That's his signature playstyle. It's great to see him in good shape in this final. Guardian will find JW, though. We may have cursed him. And that's going to be the entry frag for Na'Vi, so they have the advantage going into the remaining round of this half, the last round of this half happening right now. Na'Vi, once again, controlling mid, Guardian all the way back in T-spawn, making sure that this is actually something that doesn't happen too often, the sniper staying back in spawn that long. So, hoping to catch somebody off guard, but it's going to be an A split. Na'Vi are really trying to change up the pace here.
Oh, nice shot from Wolfmeister. He's going to pick up a double. That's the C set. He had an AWP, but he decided, wait a minute, this pistol sometimes just seems even better. And that's huge. That's a huge opening from Wolfmeister. That brings it back to a 3-on-4.
Now, that was terrific work from Wolfmeister. And now, Edward, they're going to try and change it up here. They're going to get that bomb fairly quickly. But Flusha was so close to mid doors that he certainly heard that rotation coming into upper dark. They know that there's a man up there. And you can see Flusha slowly working back up onto that B site. But this is a fake from Na'Vi. They intended for Edward to make some noise. Krims is going to peek out and see at least one guy there, but this is going to be a play for A. Olafmeister is the only line of defense alive on this site. This is it. He needs to stay alive as long as possible.
Yeah, he's missing the shot. He's down to 7 points of health, and he's not going to hit the fifth one either. He needs more, and that's Pronax helping him out. It's now 4-on-2, and if nothing else, Olafmeister staying alive and providing a pretty good dummy target here. He's going to charge in, and will he see set 75 for a triple in the round for Olafmeister? 8-7. And that's great news for Fnatic. They end up with the majority of the rounds, but I still think it's not said and done yet.
Clearly it isn't. Both of these teams are capable of the same kind of performance. I could see it going 8-7 Na'Vi's way in the next round. And this could be overtime to finish everything here, to settle the score, to settle the title between Fnatic and Na'Vi. Star Series 10 on the line, but that was Olafmeister's round. The two kills on Cat, fantastic work, but what really made that round possible, not only getting the two kills, but what made that round possible is him staying alive for that long on the A bomb site, allowing for Pronax to rotate over from long and help him, and basically just bogging Na'Vi down. The longer Na'Vi have to stay alive on Cat, the longer they just have to stand out in the open, the more opportunity for Fnatic to rotate over and just shut that bomb site down.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Just stellar play from Fnatic in that last round there. Na'Vi going for the tricky play, and you gotta like that. They send Edward running over there to make some noise, you know, trying to go for the fake. But Fnatic keeping their cool and Olafmeister there to save the day.
Now, I think the pistol round is going to be important, but I don't think it's going to be all deciding. Obviously, it'd be great for Na'Vi if they can win it and put themselves at like 10-8. If Fnatic win it, it's going to be more like 11-7. But neither of these two score lines is going to actually determine the game. What I think is going to make the big difference is how quickly Na'Vi can get an AWP on Guardian and maybe even, you know, an auto sniper or something else, you know, or another AWP. I really think this double scope rifle play on the CT side, and Fnatic waited really late to do it. I think if Na'Vi can somehow do it earlier, it might make a big difference here.
Let's see. I somehow managed to alt-tab myself out of the game, but the match is paused, so it's not the end of the world. There's still time.
We got time, Anders. Yeah, we're right on the edge. I hope you can feel it, guys. I mean, obviously, we're not in Kiev in Ukraine, but it sort of feels like the energy is still flowing out to us here. This has been such a sick Grand Finals already with three maps, and now we're on the fourth one, and Fnatic had a one-map lead, so technically it's the fifth map, this one. And a big welcome to all of you here at Room on Fire. This is the SLTV Star Series Grand Finals, second half of the absolute final map. I guess the only thing that can extend it now is overtime, and that's not even out of the question. I wouldn't rule that out either. So if you're just joining us, then welcome to the channel. I hope you're going to enjoy the content on here. And if you are, then you should definitely come back and visit in the future. We do try and cast as much Counter-Strike as we possibly can, and pretty much always working to try and see if we can do more. So that's what it
now,
is.
Tuesday night. Tuesday night is part of the schedule now. Every Tuesday night, we'll be hosting a King of the Hill tournament sponsored by Case King. And that's two best of threes that happen every Tuesday night. So if you want to tune in and enjoy some good CS, that's a good time to do it. And as far as we know, that's pretty much our fixed night. So you always know Tuesday nights there's going to be some CS. The other nights we kind of float around, but we do our best. Right now, again, paused between these two. I'm still just trying to, right now, you know, during this pause, I'm kind of digesting what we've seen throughout this entire best of five, Anders, which has been already two of the sickest maps that we have seen in a very long time, Gamescom included. from Fnatic versus NaVi at the beginning of this series. The near incredible comeback from Fnatic on Mirage, where they went 15 rounds in a row, got it into overtime, and then just barely lost to NaVi in the end in overtime. But then their insane performance on Inferno T side. So it wasn't until Train came up that NaVi were able to, you know, show that they were capable of dominance as well, that they were perfectly capable of taking maps versus Fnatic in the Grand Finals and getting back into this game, bringing us here to Dust 2, the last map where it's practically dead even between both of these teams. 8-7. I mean, do you think, what do you make of this scoreline at the end of the first half? 8-7, it's just, it still seems like, okay, we should expect to see more from Fnatic. That NaVi, you know, they didn't really get enough rounds on their T side, but at the same time, Navi's CT side can be fantastic when they fall back on Guardian with that AWP.
Yeah, I mean, this is the thing. I think if this had been, you know, at about this time last year, I would have said, oh, Fnatic, like, Navi's in a lot of trouble. Only 7 rounds on the Terror side. But because the lines have blurred quite a bit on Dust 2, I feel like 7 rounds is definitely not great. Can't really say that. But I think it's workable at this point. I think they can do it. I think Fnatic have a slight edge going into this one, obviously, but I don't know. I think it's too close to call still.
Yeah, it certainly is. This could go anyway, but the countdown has begun. We're about to get into the pistol round of our second half here. Everything on the line. Whoever gets the strong start is going to be off to, I mean, just going to have so much momentum going through the rest of this half, and Fnatic cannot be allowed to get that strong start here. NaVi have to shut them down when they are on the CT side of Dust 2 like this.
Smoke goes off into CT. Edward gunning down the middle. Pronax going to be charging through the smoke, which is a brave move, but it actually cost him his life. And Seized is fighting it out. He's very low on health, and backup is far away. He's going to go down. Olofmeister with the kill. Now Guardian and Double Doors takes down one. He's really flashed, but if they come and peek him, he's going to punish.
Yeah, not flinching. He just stands his ground and gets the kill. Now the man advantage here for NaVi. They have to take their time, and they are doing that. Starx is now in position to get the pincer movement going through upper dark. Krim's doing his best to try and...
Oh, and a little bit of lag maybe, I think? Yeah,
find a way to get the bomb plant. Zeus shoots Guardian!
Oh no, team kill. Zeus is going to go down. Starx, well, there's no bomb plant yet. And they could even run to A right now. He's going to be charging in, and he goes down. Krim's double kill, and they win the round. Whoa. I'm sorry, I think there was a bit of a hiccup there on either on GoTV or on the stream, but it should be good to go now, I think.
Oh, that's... Yeah, the pause is coming back into effect, it seems. But that was... Oh, man, Zeus kills Guardian. They have the man advantage, and Fnatic can be saying, okay, we've done some damage to these guys, we really have. But, you know, how much, right? Can we go aggressive? But Zeus killing Guardian, you see the instant reaction from Fnatic. They just go straight after Zeus. They're like, okay, screw Upper Dark. We're going to go after the guy that just shot his buddy in the back, clear him out, and then there is no way we lose this round. Fnatic just not missing out on the opportunity there given by Zeus. And that was just one click by Zeus. He was trying to see if he could get through, get somebody going across the B doors like that, but Guardian just barely got in the way. Barely got in the way. And when he was so low on HP, that's got to be really frustrating for NaVi in a pistol round.
A costly mistake, and, you know, mentally on the team too, just definitely something that's going to rattle them. But they're probably going to try and just throw it away, shake it off, and you can see them already buying a scout here. So they're ready to try and take it right back to Fnatic.
Wow, this is, I mean, they run no risk, I suppose, of going ahead and investing in this round. If Guardian can find some nice shots down Suicide to start early on, or if he can get a good spawn, perhaps, with the scout, you're so quick, you're so mobile with that gun. So we'll have to see if Guardian can pull a Sean Gares or not. That would certainly put NaVi right back into it, if they can bounce back and take an eco round. But Fnatic are so good with anti-ecos, never... Feels like never we've really had any kind of moments where that, you know, we were in doubt. Pronax is way too good about regimenting his forces and making sure that they aren't going off all by their lonesome unless their name starts with a J. But you know, it's like keeping his team tight and working together to make sure that rifles can't be given to the opponents, and more, and also that they don't run into the blender, the CZ blender.
Yeah, and I mean the CZ is always best on the CT side, but Dust 2 is not the greatest map for it, I would say. A map like Inferno or Nuke is sometimes a little bit better because the terrorists have to get a little bit closer, but it can still be done. We've seen it done plenty of times already, so no doubt Fnatic are going to try and think about that in the upcoming round. Just starting Counter-Strike, so he should be back in any second, guys. Patience is the key word here.
That's certainly it. But it's also patience for the team. And this is the thing. This is the second pause now where they've had something come up. I mean, they already had pauses happen earlier on when we started the finals because Olaf Meister was clumsy enough to spill his drink everywhere, basically. So that was a funny pause at the start. But now, in the final map especially, in a marathon, basically, that is a best of five. I mean, hell, you play two maps at this level, three maps at this level, and that's hugely demanding physically, mentally, on both of these teams, on all of these players. In Na'Vi's case, they've already played a best of three today as well. So they're going into the finals after, 45 minutes break? After one best of three, they go into a best of five. So this is hugely demanding on Na'Vi. Fnatic as well. I mean, there's just the level of focus that you have to maintain for this long. It's turned into a real marathon here, and the pauses aren't helping. This is really turning into who can keep their focus despite all of the things that are slowing down these games that the players unfortunately have no control over.
Yes, and I mean, that's a really good point, actually, because Na'Vi's match in the consolidation finals against Hellraisers, that went all three maps, and it was by no means an easy tour for Na'Vi. So they played three maps there, now they're in the fourth map here. That's seven maps they've played in one day. That definitely does take its toll. And, well, we'll see. I mean, they're sort of veterans at doing it, but I think it's still going to be tough.
Yeah, I mean, you can do all the training and everything like that, but, you know, that's certainly not something to be taken lightly. But okay, enough of the pauses, enough of the chitter-chatter, let's get into the match. Fnatic up 9-7 right now, 17th round, and we shall see what they've got in store for us here, seeing as how JW is only going CZ. Straight up, three rifles bought by Fnatic, and they did the same thing on Inferno. This has been a go-to strategy in the second round for Fnatic.
Guardian, he jumped and adjusted his aim mid-air to take down Crims. That was a mind-bending shot from Guardian. That should not be allowed to have happened there. Sometimes you really do wonder just what's in the groundwater in Slovakia to make Guardian this good. And he's going to be charged up on here, and he will go down to JW, so that's a good return frag, but that was still very impressive.
Oh, and good damage dealt to Caesar as well, who's alive on this B side, but he's down to 28 HP. There is a man waiting around the corner. That's Edward, who gets dropped on, and Pronax looks for the shot, and he gets it? That was a bit weird, a bit wonky. Oh, it's JW, but Pronax will be taking it. Don't worry about that. A two-man advantage now for Fnatic, and they get the bomb planted as well with ample time.
JW stolen the EWP and doing some good damage here. Shouldn't be possible for Na'Vi to get back in here, and especially now that they've been softened up quite a bit, so they actually have kits and armor to save, so they're going to run away, which is not a bad idea.
No, they've got, I mean, if you look at the equipment value bar at the very top, you know, you can see 50 grand on Fnatic with four members left alive, but there's still $3,200 on Na'Vi. That's a lot of money for just two guys. I mean, just in the pistols alone and the armor, you're looking at $1,800 right there. So that's, $2,800 right there between the pistols and the armor on Na'Vi. So it's a lot of money that you can think about putting into the next round here. It's not until the 19th round that you're going to see a big buy coming out from Na'Vi. So whatever damage they can get done in this round here, in the 18th, that's gravy for Na'Vi. It's all about getting Fnatic to spend money in these rounds, making sure that if Na'Vi win that 19th round, Fnatic are likely going to be ecoing.
Yes, indeed. And 10-7, we did say it was pretty good. Oh, well, Seuss. CSET 75 action on an Olafmeister level there. But from CT spawn, Olafmeister, Speak of the Devil, is going to try and fight it out. Still a great opening kill.
Good damage dealt. Seuss is still hanging around at Cat, but it's not going to be a problem until he decides to push up. And is he going to hear this? The stomping around at long. He now knows that they are out on long. He's commuting that. Look at that. The U-turn by Na'Vi. They were rotating to B. They instantly turn around and get back to A. As soon as Zeus tells them they're out on long, that we lost control of this A site. You guys need to get there fast.
Yeah, but Flusher came up and saw Zeus, and that means now they know they're caught as well. Huge timing from Flusher. Just spotting him probably could have saved Fnatic in this round. That was... I mean, Flusher, you know, he couldn't know that there was going to be someone there when he walked up, but the fact that he was there just that second, if he had been there 1 second later, that could have been horrible for Fnatic.
That would have been brutal, you're right. Guardian is still trying to get a jump shot with the scout, and that sets it up for Seized. Pronax has only got 11 HP right now. It's going to be Flusher who has to stand his ground and take the brunt of the damage. Seized only 4 HP, gets on that bomb, tries to bait out Flusher. But Flusher ain't having none of that. Flusher will hold on to an AK, Pronax will as well, and that's the important thing. But as I was saying, the real goal here for Na'Vi, sure, winning the round would have been fantastic, but this is still a win for them, because look at all the money they're forcing Fnatic to spend in this round.
That they are, and the road into a comeback here from NaVi is definitely going to be paved with Fnatic Ecos. That's what it's down to. That's what they have to get done. Not just one or two, but probably a couple of them before this round is done, or for the game is over. And at least they can afford an AWP as well on Guardian, so things aren't looking too bad for NaVi. But I think if they lose this round, I'm not sure the Fnatic landslide is going to stop at any point soon.
It's going to get out of control, Anders. They're on the favorite side as well, and Fnatic are very good about making the right calls. JW misses his flick shot. Edward manages to hunt him down. They're looking for the refrag, but they're taking too long, and it turns into the crossfire at mid. NaVi jump on the opportunity, sees is alive on B site, and picks off the first man. Pronax is the last man alive in a 1v4, and Zeus to the rescue. Three frags for Zeus. That was excellent play there. Fnatic with a big missed opportunity. You have to give it to Edward. He gets that first frag, and then he stays alive long enough to bait Fnatic out in the open and buy time for Zeus to walk through CT smoke and get into that fight.
Yeah, I mean, this was an essential round from NaVi, right? And they managed to play it out really well. 11-8, and moving right into the 20th round. Fnatic can still buy, and if they lose, though, they're going to be back on ecoing. And at that point, I mean, it's basically 10-11, so... Yeah, NaVi's definitely not out of it yet. This could go the full distance.
Yeah, certainly can. This is all over the place. And Fnatic lose this round, they're ecoing. NaVi could run it back at any point in time. Guardian's got his AWP, they've got the rifles and nades right now. This is very close, but this is exactly how it should be on the final map of the Grand Finals. We shouldn't be able to just say, oh, this is a stomp. This is going this way, right? I'm so glad it's this close right now on this map. Fnatic working their way out Cat, but there is the man, the myth, the legend, the G-Rex, alive at cross, looking towards Cat with that AWP.
He's going to go back to support long, and as long as he doesn't go down, it's fine that he doesn't get too many kills here. But Fnatic, I'm maybe going to try and cheat them a little bit, because they got the bomb all the way around upper dark, so I'm thinking this is going to be a classic B-split push. And the question is if this position from Zeus is really going to pay off. On top of the box, and inside the B bomb site, there's also Edward and C. So either way, this is great. And Guardian stops Pronax from coming in on short.
Yeah, perfect flick. Gets the kill. Zeus is trying to work his way through CT, gives away his position, and Flusha will find the headshot on Seized instead. Oddly enough, this is the B site cleared in the blink of an eye. Flusha with two entry frags. Olafmeister finding Zeus at CT. Guardian is hunting for Olaf, and he will find him. And that happened fast enough that maybe now NaVi try and make a fight of this, because they know Flusha's low. If they can get in here fast enough, and they have the incendiary for back plateau, Crims is about to get roasted. It's too hot. He's jumping out of the way, but he gets out onto the box on time, and he's not exposed.
Smart thinking from Crims. If he had been forced out there, Starish would have taken him down, and it would have been a really awkward 2-on-2. So that's just, you know, you got to think really quickly at that point. If you stick around too long, you're just going to straight up die. So even though Crims didn't give up a kill that round, I think he could have given an opening to NaVi if he had been acting a little bit less thoughtfully there. So that's 12-8 now. So four-round difference.
Very quick reactions from Crims, and you're absolutely right. If he gets forced out and Starks gets that kill, then I think NaVi commit. I think Starks goes rushing through window and tries to jump on that opportunity. Well, NaVi, this is where it starts to really get scary for them, and you can see that right now in what they're doing with their money. They're forcing up, going for the rifles, whatever nades they can get their hands on at this point. They need to stop Fnatic here if they want to have a chance, and Guardian with the kill on Olafmeister to start is going to be a terrific first blow dealt.
Yeah, and he was actually AFK in spawn. His computer crashed again. So that's very bad, and I don't actually blame Fnatic for asking for a restart, because normally you don't do... Yeah, they told him off that this is like a technical thing. This is going to be really personal. Like, I mean, it is true. Generally, if you want to pause, you do it in the freeze time. But because he crashed in spawn, actually in sight of Guardian, then it gets tricky.
Alright, well, this is something...
Look, this... Right here, Semler, right here is where I'm so happy that I'm not the admin that has to make this choice. Because...
Well, the rules should clearly define what happens. But at the same time, they shouldn't be holding this chat live and around.
No, especially not because if it's going to cause a lot of frustration, that's going to be affecting Fnatic a lot. I mean, if the admin comes back now and says, yeah, you're going to have to play the round out, that could really come back to bite them. So they should.
Well, it doesn't matter. You reload it. You reload it from the last round. Right now, what happens is Fnatic play through the round, and a ruling is made at the end of freeze time, isn't it?
Well... That's up to the admin, right? We can speculate all day. I don't know. I think I don't blame Fnatic really for wanting to restart that, but at the same time, it's not Na'Vi's fault either. Yeah, they'll load
the
backup.
Yeah, they're gonna load the backup.
All right. I think that's I don't know. It's really hard to apply the term fairness in a competition, but I think if we had to, I'd say that's probably the more fair choice, right?
Yeah, if it's unfortunate timing where they didn't actually realize that Olaf Meister timed out, then yeah. Then I guess, right?
Yeah. So, we're just going to be in. You can luckily reload. Hopefully there's no issue with the backup. Ebot should be running and helping us out. So that's good. Good news.
I think they need to be, it's going to be important for Na'Vi here as well. That's still such an important round for Na'Vi. So you can understand Seized being like, well, but the Coca-Cola was legendary. Yeah, the Coke that Olaf Meister spilled all over the place at the beginning of this. Terrific.
Yeah. And it's not like Na'Vi are going to have a disadvantage because of this reload either. You know, they're just not going to get the entry frag, maybe at least on an AFK Olaf Meister. So that's rough, but hopefully not going to impact either team too much. We're up to 64,000 viewers almost, and I think our record for the channel is 65. So invite your friends if you haven't already. We're breaking all sorts of records tonight. We've also broken the sub record and the follow record, and everything is just really amazing. So you guys have made it worthwhile. And really appreciate that. I don't know, I mean, Samuel, it's been a pretty long day, and yesterday was also a long day, and I woke up with a terrible fever, and it's actually coming back on me now. So I'm glad that we got all these people here to help us out and make it a really great day anyway. I'm so happy we didn't decide to cancel the show based on a little fever, right?
No, this is cool, man, and you're champ, Anders. You're sticking it out, man. Soon I'll be able to return the favor.
Yeah, that's true. Once you get good internet, man, then we're going to be up and running.
Yeah, then this sort of thing, when you've got a fever, you're good, man. But right now, it's still a matter of just keeping keeping everybody's focus. Our focus, viewers' focus, you guys don't want to blink. You don't want to miss any of the action, but it's also keeping the players focused on what... Oh, wait, I forgot push to talk. You see, that's the thing, man. It's wearing on all of us at this point, this pause thing.
It is. I think I've made a couple of mistakes. I think at the beginning of this half, I managed to call a scout and AWP and stuff like that. You know, sometimes, you know, first of all, we're getting old, and it's also getting late. This is way past our bedtime, right? So it's slipping for us. It's slipping for us.
Yeah, we're Fifloran now. Fifloran, he's always just like, man, once it gets past midnight, you know, I can't keep my eyes open. And I'm like, man, we're getting old. This is it, you know. Let me go get you my cane.
Yeah, well, not old enough to not win in a grand finals, I guess. So there's something to be said about that.
Or lift that cup one-handed. What's up? Fifloran been working out. Heaton, man, he's keeping his eyes on his team, making sure those guys are fit.
It would be kind of scary if all of NIP really started, you know, to try and emulate Heaton. I think that would be, you know, what a team, right? You hate to lose, you know, or even win against them on land. You know, what if they just come and smash you? Scary thought, man.
Dude, Heaton is kind of like, Heaton is scary, man. Imagine him walking around with like a beard, mustache, and like the braids, you know, like full out Viking. Like, he's kind of what you picture the Viking is, because he's massive, he's huge, and he looks like he can break you in half over his knee.
Well, you know what, like, that's one of the things I really found interesting. There's some footage out there of when NIP won the finals at Gamescom, and Heaton, for, you know, as big as he is and as intimidating as he seems, that footage when he's there and you can basically tell that he's praying. He looks like a little kid. He looks like, you know, a child really hoping for the best to happen. It's actually, I think, a very emotional recording.
Yeah, it is.
It's very cool. In general, I think everyone who was there taking pictures and videos did a really fine job, and I still haven't looked through all of them, but that was a very cool moment, I think.
I'm sure somebody could find it and put it in the chat, or if you want, just like search, I guess, like Heaton Gamescom Finals or something like that. But yeah, definitely cool to see his reaction. I mean, that's the thing. For so long, Heaton has put everything into that team. So for so long, they've been waiting for that title to be theirs, and finally they get it, right? And after such a nerve-wracking tournament as well. You know, never stop believing. Like, if you never give up, never surrender, that is NIP. That entire tournament long, they never gave up, and they actually got that major.
Well, they took it away from Fnatic, who are now fighting to win a tournament of their own here. They're just four rounds away. Na'Vi, aggressive boost up here, and oh, they line up. That's a double shot. Crims is down to 20. That is devastating. Guardian striking back after the pause is done with.
But Starx is going to peek out at long. He sees two guys pushing up here. This is going to be Pronex peeking around the corner, walks right into Starx. Flusha spots out Starx as well, but he can't take advantage of it. Olafmeister gets overrun on Cat, and Na'Vi are just swarming all over Fnatic at this point. Flusha is the last man alive at long, but he has no escape. He can't get out of here. Zeus has already cut off his line of retreat.
That'd have been a headshot. Yeah, they're going to find him. If that had been a headshot from Guardian, actually, it's a team ace, just to clarify. Everybody on Na'Vi picked up one kill each, but if that had been a headshot on the line of people running in, then I think it could actually be a triple kill. And look at Guardian. He's with smileys and everything. Pretty excited. I don't blame him.
Dude, Guardian is always giggling, man. Even like, I still remember when Nuke came up as the last map at Gamescom versus Fnatic, you know, Guardian instantly just starts laughing at himself and, like, face palms. Like, doesn't matter, you know. Guardian, you can't keep him down.
Oh, Fnatic trying not to be kept down either. Rushing through the firewall there is actually going to be JW just charging in, and it actually takes them a good while to kill him. And now the rest are coming in. It is an eco round, and they're doing a good job holding on here. Fnatic, they get one kill on C's, but they can't get the bomb down, and Olafmeister's trapped in a corner. Does some damage, which is still good news, but it will be 12-11.
Slowly but surely, Na'Vi are working their way back in here, but what's more important is they're developing a bank, so they have a cushion, a pillow, as Ven would say, to fall back on right now. Fnatic, however, are going to go for a force buy. So Pronax straight up, AK, Kevlar, couple flashes, JW just has to go Galil. So Fnatic, man, they're really having to stretch themselves right now. These pauses have not been helping them, whereas Na'Vi, it's bought them time to breathe, brought them time to recover somewhat and now, set up the proper defense to deal with the Fnatic offense.
To go back to the beginning of this half here, my prediction was that the turning point was going to be when Na'Vi managed to pick up two scope rifles, and right now they have the one unseized, and it allows them to basically put him alone in the B bomb site. So look at the A defense right now, is quite stunning. They're going to be flashed out here. Crims can still see, and he's boosted up. He's going to be spraying down, but he goes down, and Pronax can't return the kill just yet.
Not an ideal situation. Pronax still manages to pick up one. JW, in the meantime, has picked up one on the other side. Olafmeister is now about to get out onto A site, but Starx instantly cuts him down off a Cat. Great shot there from Starx with that AWP, who is perfectly capable of sniping, as we see. But Flusha is now the only man alive here for Fnatic, the Clutchmaster himself, out on long, and Edward is already on the hunt. This smoke is actually working in Flusha's favor, though. If he gets in between them, this could be big. And he gets behind Edward, and he gets behind Starx as well. The double kill from Flusha! He does it! It's a 1v1!
Oh, Seas is here with the auto-sniper. Flusha gonna charge in, and he goes down after such a sick play. Flusha has to be one of the coolest players in this sense. Not many people would have the composure to get both those kills in such a clean, almost surgical precision there. And it's still not enough. That's heartbreaking. And now we're at 12-11, unlike last time when I also said it was going to be 12-11. You guys are going to have to count for yourselves, all right? Counting is really hard, especially at this time.
That was fantastic. Yeah, we okay. Counting is hard, but Flusha, what a play. And for him to take the time to turn around and check cross, that's the thing. He could have jumped it and gone for Edward, but then he risks dying to Starx. But he actually takes the time to turn around from the guaranteed kill, check for Starx. I mean, that was just masterful right there from Flusha. Great reaction, however, to get caught up. Well, I mean, the thing is that the Na'Vi defense was not broken.
Pronax with a 180. Oh my god, he's going to pick up a triple kill. That is an insane reaction. That's Hiko skills coming out there. That 180 from Pronax, that's going to be in a lot of replays. My god, that was sick. Now it's 12-12. They still lose the round, but that was an eco from Fnatic. They take three people with them, and Na'Vi's economy is suffering. I mean, this is important. This is very, very important. That triple kill from Pronax can win them the game when it goes late.
No, it can. That's going to have an effect. We can already see it. Three guys are low on money for Na'Vi right now. Fnatic, they have enough money to go for a pretty healthy buy. JW with the AWP and Kevlar. Pronax gets into Lower Dark fast, but Guardian manages to catch him off guard. And Zeus, not sure if Pronax spotted him, but Zeus is going to catch Olafmeister off guard. Two kills coming in for Na'Vi already.
That's big. And the problem is Fnatic, they're spread out across the map. They're not in one bunch, so they can't really fight their way in anywhere. And they're completely paranoid. They have no idea where the remaining Na'Vi members are actually holding.
Oh man, look at Zeus's position right now. He's all the way up in T-spawn. Flusha, is he going to walk right into it? Flusha checks. And Zeus aiming for the headshot, not quite finding it. One bullet would do it. Flusha with the pop flash, and he manages to pick Zeus out of the air. But still, Na'Vi maintaining the advantage for now. They've got a man lead. Seas has been spotted in Upper Dark, and Flusha is on fire right now. Flusha, he is the man turning the tide.
Yeah, and that's, I think, at the very beginning when we introduced these teams, it was that was one of the points brought up, right? Flusher is like that ace up the sleeve that sometimes he just puts himself into overdrive, and that's what they need right now. If Fnatic lose this round, they really won't have that great of an economy. The same is true for Na'Vi. A lot hangs on the balance here.
Absolutely. And Flusher getting tagged, but JW is still alive. Only problem is that Guardian is still here as well. This is going to take a fantastic shot from JW. But Guardian is holding on A slope. He repositions himself at the last second, and that actually opens up the opportunity here for Fnatic to go in behind the flash. But Starx is now here, and with 10 seconds left, Flusher going for the spray, gets caught by Guardian, and it's going to be JW alive in a 1v2 with 4 seconds left. Not enough time to go anywhere at all. Guardian shoots him in the back, no mercy, and Na'Vi are actually in the lead with the round.
Guardian right now, as it's been the story almost all tournament, not all maps, but I think the majority, if Na'Vi win, it's generally Guardian on top of the scoreboard. 23 kills, 21 on Flusher, and Fnatic are going to force it up again. They've lost a lot of rounds in a row, so I don't blame them, but this is the first time I think that Na'Vi have the round lead, or at least sort of can keep the round lead as well, maybe.
And already damage dealt to Olafmeister here by Na'Vi. Fnatic now spreading out across the map at this point. 1-3-1. They're going back to the basics. Oh, Crims!
That was Guardian just randomly flicking at the door, and because Olafmeister's already low. This is a disaster for Fnatic.
Yeah, they're taking damage everywhere. This is disheartening. This just makes your life so much more difficult here. If you've already taken damage to the point where one bullet from anything pretty much takes you out of the game, Fnatic have to be so careful, but they're grouping up. Everybody at mid, but look at the position from Zeus. He's right on the other side of the doors. He's listening right now so hard for any kind of information that would give away Fnatic's intent. Intentions, rather.
I mean, what are they going to do? Fnatic really spending a lot of time thinking about every move, and Pronax jumps down in CT spawn, and they kill Zeus. Now that is a big opening. Now it's down to Edward and Season's bombsite, and backup's going to be miles away.
Backup is only just now coming through. Pronax is still alive in CT spawn, catches Guardian on the other side of this smoke. Seized, however, alive on the site proper, gets 3 kills. He could take out Flusher, but he runs out of bullets in his M4A1, and we're into the 1v1, or rather the 1v2 now, as Starx is the last man alive, running all the way over from A site, but still, he's right outside B, just as that bomb gets planted. He still has time to make a play here, and he's got a Molotov as well.
Yeah, that's gonna... Actually, it's not gonna force Pronax anywhere, so it lands on the wrong side. This is going to be tricky. He's going to walk in and should be going down. Flushes down there, but it will be Pronax to pick up the kill. And Fnatic are back at 13-13. And they almost made a critical and absolutely momentous or monstrous mistake in that bomb site. I don't know if you caught this, Eleanor, but one of the guys actually ran in with the bomb on and just tried to straight plant in before they cleared the bomb site. That could have lost them the whole round.
I think if Seized has an M4A4 in that position, he gets that quad kill. Like, that's the thing. I mean, great control from Seized, getting 3 frags with an M4A1 without even reloading. But if he has 10 extra bullets, he gets 4 kills. He tombs Fnatic single-handedly on that B site right there. So, Na'Vi, that was an opportunity missed, but they're not out of it yet. They go for the straight-up force. They're not willing to give up the Fnatic here. They're fighting to the very bitter end, and it's a scout picked up on Seized. Guardian has enough for an AWP. 3 rifles to complement, and Edward at the mid-doors looking for the opportunity, and there you go. Drops JW and drops the bomb.
Oh, but he falls back a little bit too quick, and actually he's going to get taken down. Nice play from Fnatic to return the frag immediately. But this is scary. Either team loses this round, they're going to be ecoing, and it's even worse for Na'Vi. They might be double ecoing, in fact. Well, they probably can't, but they would be forced to if they had to. There it is. Zeus going to pick up the kill in behind, and Crims comes through. That's a triple here from Crims, and now Fnatic are close to the victory. They can feel it. Now we will have no money in the upcoming round. In fact, they should definitely save this.
No, they back up now. If they can get Pronax, they can. The bomb hasn't been planted yet. Guardian is so low, though, only 20 HP, but Starks has now got an AK to work with. If Guardian could have found the shot there at B doors, that would have been big. Crims is still waiting on the other side, but he's on the side proper now, and Starks, they only have a decoy to work with. There are no nades. There's only a decoy nade here for Na'Vi to take this retake.
It's going to be tough. It's ticking away. They do have a kit picked up here, and Flusher is going to be alone one-on-one. He runs away, which is exactly what he wants to do. Starx needs to pick up the kit and either run or fake it once, and I think he can afford only one fake here. Flusher is going to be charging in. Starx is there ready and waiting. He's going to get the kill, but there's no time. They still lose the round, and Fnatic make it to 14. And Na'Vi, while they save the AK, that's not enough here. They are not going to have much money at all.
They have hardly any at all. They're floating around 2250. 2250 or 1950, but Na'Vi now, they go for it. They have to, they're going to go for a CZ buy. You got to admire this. This is Na'Vi saying, okay, we're putting it all on the last round. Like, this is Na'Vi really just going on the pistols, and Starks is AK. Fnatic managed to get a pretty good buy together. JW with the AWP again.
It's interesting, yeah, because Na'Vi could have forced up with armor and C-sets and grenades, but the fact that they don't means they are either going to count on the C-sets working, which is still a big risk to take. They might be good, but you can't just rely on them winning a round for you like this. And if not, they're going to fight for overtime.
Yeah, that's exactly it. They're playing for overtime at this point. So this is a big commitment here from Na'Vi. They're like, okay, regular time, we're not going to risk it all. We're going to go for guns. Zeus peeks out Olafmeister. Olafmeister with the HE. Zeus just running in, and Olafmeister point blank manages to get the spray down. 19 health left on him, and that was a very close call.
Scary as hell, yeah. Starix is still in this bomb site. He's got the AK in hand. Gonna go for the spray here. He's just not gonna pick off Pronax. That was could have been a very important kill. Now it's a 5-on-3. It seems like Fnatic are gonna be able to get up into the bomb site and deal with Na'Vi, putting themselves at match, map, and tournament point with 15 rounds. Seized and Edward, they really can't do anything in this 2-on-5.
They're so close, they have to try and make a run for it, and Edward barely makes it into CT, but he's only got a CZ to hold on to here. If he could find Olafmeister or Pronax, that would be fantastic. That would be like Christmas come early for him. Just do any damage at all. But they're already backing off. Olafmeister's still on cat, though. But Edward's about to get given away. There we go. Crim spots him from mid-doors, and now Edward just trying to run into that site.
I mean, he was hoping to kill someone and then pick up the rifle and save it, which is actually a very, very good idea from Edward, but he's still going to go down, looping around CT spawn, and there it is. That sound.
Oh, this is it, man. It's all or nothing now, Na'Vi. Do they win it or not? Do we go to overtime or not?
Well, if they win a round, then Fnatic can still make a buy in the upcoming round. They're going to get 1,400 on top of the almost 3,000 they have on three of their players. That will be enough to force, not a great buy, but a reasonable buy. So Na'Vi basically have to win two rounds in a row here. They're going to be charging out, and that's the opening here. JW also tagged up a little bit, but a great start from Starix here.
All right, very well done. And Fnatic backing off, not overcommitting to this either, not trying to force it. Starix going for spray, though. And Starks, that was that. I mean, not sure if he knew that JW was there, but still, JW does not miss an opportunity like that. Gets the return frag and brings it back to a 4-on-4. Advantage Fnatic very clearly, and Edward taking some spray through the doors right now.
Yeah, and as you were praising Fnatic for not trying to force the issue, that's exactly what Na'Vi did, and they did not have much of a reason to do it. So that's actually a pretty costly mistake. That could cost them a lot here. JW's going to go down, seized, holding his ground. He's going to go be taken down, though, and now that's the A, or the B-bomb site, sorry, very much open for business.
And Guardian closing in as well. They're losing people left and right at this point. It's all down to Crims, and it's fitting indeed. Bit of a hiccup there, but Crims will get taken out. He's looking for Zeus, but Zeus up close with the M4 will get the job done. And we are going to the final round, the 30th round, the round of rounds. And Fnatic, they have a mixed buy. They don't have enough for an AWP for JW. They hardly have enough for AKs.
Yeah, this is the problem, but they can make it. It's not like Na'Vi have exactly great equipment, although they do have the AWP here, but this is still going to be really tricky, and at this point in time, man, the pressure is on for every single player in this match.
It's terrific. This is what a final should end on. And now Fnatic are just pushing out. They're taking control of long. They aren't wasting any time at all. Smoke to go down to cut off the cross, and Starks gets caught out in the open. JW with the opening frag. Now they need to find a way to get across here, but Guardian is holding the gap, and he only legs JW.
That would have been a very important kill. Another one to jump by here. Guardian misses it. Now it's a 5-on-3. Fnatic, they're very close. They can feel that victory coming here. And it's going to be back to a 3-on-3, but they have the health advantage. Zeus and Seized will have to play out of their minds. And that's their first opening kill from Zeus. He's picked up a double. The bomb is down. It's overtime or loss here for Na'Vi.
And they're both tagged up. Seized does wrap around through long, but Fnatic aren't playing for long. They are going to look back in time, and now Seized is caught out completely in the open, but Zeus turns it into a 1v1. Flusha alive on A slope, trying to hold as best he can. Zeus jumps down, tries to find the angle, but Flusha instantly reacts, playing for the bomb, just trying to burn as much time off of this clock, and Zeus will go down. Fnatic take it 16-14 in the 30th round of the last map. They take the title away, and Na'Vi will have to settle for second place.
And there it is, the defending champions fall, and Fnatic getting cheated last time at Gamescom. They do take the trophy here at SLTV Star Series. So congratulations to the Swedish team. They've definitely been working hard to get to this place, and that's gonna be a real celebration. I wish we had live shots of it, but we don't. Now, guys, it's been one hell of a long day. We started casting 11. It's almost 11. We've been doing 12-hour broadcast here on the channel. So thank you for joining us. If you want to help us out, we're going to leave the channel open for a little bit, and we're just going to play some ads. So stick around and watch some ads if you want to help us. Follow and subscribe and all that stuff. But for now, I think I at least need to go and take care of my fever. And Semler, you should go and sleep.
Yeah, I'm just going to sleep. I'm going to go back and just relax and play all this over in my mind. Have a fantastic evening, everybody. Thank you all for tuning in, and be sure to tune in this Tuesday night for the Case King of the Hill. NIP are playing. They are the current title holders, so they'll be defending their title Tuesday night in a best of three. So we'll see you then.
That is all. Good night, guys.